In this video, we are going to discuss Laplace transform and ROC of rising exponential. In last two classes, we discussed the same for decaying exponential in both left and right regions. So, here we are going to find out the Laplace transform and ROC of rising exponential, that means e power plus at, both in right and left regions. So, in right region means e power at multiplied with u of t, in left region means e power plus at multiplied with u of minus t. So, now I want to trace the signal first. So, first we will deal with e power at u of t. So, first I want to trace this signal. So, e power at is a rising exponential. It will rise from minus infinity to infinity. And we are having u of t. U of t is equivalent to 1 from 0 to infinity. So, if you multiplied these two signals, then you are getting a rising part of rising exponential. So, why? Because here you are having 0, 0 into this part will become 0. So, you will get this one. So, this is e power at u of t. For this, you need to find out the Laplace transform as well as ROC. So, to find Laplace transform of that signal, so first we need fundamental Laplace transform equation. Laplace transform of any signal x of t is equivalent to integral minus infinity to infinity signal into e power minus st dt. This is Laplace transform of x of t. So, now here if you want Laplace transform of e power at u of t, in place of signal you need to substitute that. That means we need Laplace transform of e power at into u of t. So, that is equivalent to integral minus infinity to infinity e power at u of t into e power minus st dt. Now, this is equivalent to, as we are having unit step function in integration, as we know that unit step function u of t is having value from 0 to infinity, that value is equivalent to 1. From 0 to minus infinity, your value is equivalent to 0, u of t value is equivalent to 0. So, I am taking out that unit step function and I am changing my limits. Unit step function will change the limits as 0 to infinity. And remaining I am taking common of minus s minus a into t. I am writing minus t as common and I am writing s minus a dt. So, if you done this integration, then you are going to get e power minus s minus a into t divided by minus s minus a, and the limits are 0 to infinity. If you substituted your upper limit, you are going to get 0. And if you substitute lower limit, when you are taking lower limit, you need to take minus. When you substitute lower limit, e power 0 is equivalent to 1, 1 by minus s minus a. So, this is equivalent to 1 by s minus a. So, finally, the Laplace transform of the signal e power at u of t, that means right sided rising exponential, is equivalent to 1 by s minus a. Now, this is the time to consider the ROC, region of convergence of this spectrum. So, now by this spectrum, if you want real of s, you need to equate this denominator equivalent to 0. That means s minus a is equivalent to 0. Then you will get, if you equate equivalent to 0, you will get s is equivalent to a. You know that s is equivalent to sigma plus j omega. So, here you are not having any j part. So, that way sigma is equivalent to a. So, real of s is equivalent to a. So, now when you are writing region of convergence, your real part of s, that means sigma, is equivalent to a. When you are writing ROC, you need to consider either greater than or less than. How we can take that? That means we can take greater than or less than, that can be decided by the signal itself. Observe the signal. Signal is a right sided signal or left sided signal? The resultant signal, that means e power at u of t, is a purely right sided signal. When your signal is purely right sided signal, when you are writing ROC, then you need to consider greater than. If your signal is left sided signal and you are writing ROC, then you need to consider real of S less than that real part. But here the signal is right sided signal, so I need to consider greater than A. So the ROC diagram will be like this. You need to mention A. A means definitely in the left half of S plane. So all these values are sigma, all these values are j omega. This is S plane. In S plane, where A is going to consider means definitely in the positive half of real part. So here this is A. When you mentioned that pole, you need to draw a strip line parallel to imaginary axis, and how you can cover the ROC means according to this. This is the ROC of this signal e power a t u of t. Real of S greater than A. Greater than A means like this. Real of S greater than A. And coming to this signal, second signal. So now I am considering minus e power a t u of minus t, this signal. First I want to trace the signal nature. So e power plus a t means again rising exponential, u of minus t means left sided unit step, and if you multiply these two, you are going to get decaying part of rising exponential, this one, and as you are having minus, then you will get signal like this. This signal will get mirror image as we are having minus here. So this is minus e power a t u of minus t. For this signal you need to get Laplace transform and its ROC. So now to consider Laplace transform, I am taking same equation. So I need Laplace transform of minus e power a t u of minus t. For this I am just substituting in place of x of t, I am substituting this signal minus e power a t u of minus t, minus infinity to infinity e power s t dt. So now this is equivalent to, as we are having u of minus t here, the limits are from 0 to infinity. Why? Because your left sided unit step is having value from 0 to minus infinity. From 0 to infinity, that unit step value is equivalent to 0. That's why that unit step function is limiting this integration from minus infinity to 0, and the remaining is this minus I am writing outside, remaining I am taking common of t. So s, so I am taking common of minus, I am taking like this minus s minus a, e power minus s t dt. Actually in formula itself we are having e power minus s t. So I am taking common of minus, so s minus a into t dt. So now you can see, so this is equivalent to, when you are minus, when you are having minus here, you can change the integration to 0 to infinity. That means if you want to change minus infinity to 0 to 0 to infinity, you can take minus. Already you are having minus means minus of minus plus. So 0 to infinity e power minus s minus a into t dt. So you just need to do this integration divided by minus s minus a. You need to substitute the limits. So when you applied upper limit, you are getting 0, e power minus infinity is 0, 0 by anything is 0. While writing lower limit, you need to consider minus. So if you take in 0 here, e power minus 0 is equivalent to e power 0, e power 0 is equivalent to 1, 1 by minus s minus a. So you are getting 1 by s minus a as equivalent. So if you are getting 1 by s minus a, if you want to write ROC for this signal, that means region of convergence of this signal, so we need to equate this to 0 to get the pole. So now here you are getting s is equivalent to a. S is equivalent to a means there is no imaginary part. S is nothing but sigma plus j omega, like this. There is no imaginary part. Real part is a. So ROC is, ROC is real of S is a. Whether we need to take greater than and less than, that can be decided by the signal. Here you can see the resultant signal. Resultant signal is purely left sided signal. For left sided signals you need to consider less than. So ROC is real of S less than a. So if you want to draw the ROC, you need to consider S plane. which is having both sigma plus j omega as axis. This is S plane. So in S plane, your poly is at A. So your poly is at A means you need to draw a strip line parallel to imaginary axis touching that pole, and here the ROC is real of S less than A. Less than A means this side. It's covering total S plane where real of S less than A. Less than A region, this is going to cover, this signal is going to cover this region. This signal is going to cover this region. So you can see, is there any combination in between these two? Real of S is not having any combination region. It's having only similarity at that pole only. Real of S is equal to A will be its your ROC. There is no region of coverage. Region of convergence is not there. If you combine these two signals, if you combine e power a t u of t plus minus e power a t u of minus t, then we won't get any region of convergence. That is the meaning. You can see these two diagrams. Is there any combination region? Means there won't be any combination region. So ROC will get 0 when we combine these two signals. And here we can observe, for both signals e power a t u of t and e power a t u of minus t, you are getting same Laplace transform 1 by s minus a. When you saw e power plus a t, just put 1 by s minus a. But ROC is different. So finally, I'm going to take a table of this exponentials. I'm going to consider the table of exponentials. If you are having e power a t u of t, if you are having e power a t u of minus t, if you are having e power minus a t u of t, if you are having e power minus a t u of minus t. So now I am writing transforms and ROCs directly. So the transform, Laplace transform and ROC I am writing. As I am having e power plus a t, I will get 1 by s minus a. ROC is real of s greater than or less than, means here you are having u of t. So greater than a. So whatever a is there, that you will write. So here also when you saw plus a, you will get minus a. But here real of s less than a because u of minus t. And here 1 by s plus a because you are having e power minus a t. So you will take s plus a, but real of s is greater than a. Why? Because here this is a right sided sequence. So for this also the Laplace transform is e power minus a t u of minus t 1 by s plus a. But ROC is varied for this too, and this is less than a because this is a left sided sequence. So this is very very important shortcut for gate. We already derived in last two classes. So these are mandatory exponential that you need to keep in mind when you are going to any technical exam. They will change a value. They will give e power b to u of t. Then what is the problem? There is, we are not having any problem. For example, in place of a, they can give 1 by 2, e power t by 2 if they given, e power t by 2, e power t by 2, u of t if they given. So in place of a, you are having 1 by 2. Then how? 1 by s minus 1 by 2. That means 2 by 2s minus 1. You will get 2 by 2s minus 1 as transform. Like that, you can trace any transform of the signal. When it's having exponential as signal, you can trace the transform and as well as ROCs. This is very very important. In that case, in this case, real of s greater than 1 by 2. So for example, if they give an e power t by 2 u of t, real of s greater than 1 by 2, and the transform they may give like this or like this, simplified transform or normal transform they will give. This is about Laplace transform of exponentials. Especially in this video we covered rising exponential, in last two videos we covered decaying exponential, right sided and left sided.